Well, Morgan and I are making moves to get underway, leaving St. George's Bay in Newfoundland, and we're gonna head out and around the corner to the next place to anchor, about 100 miles away. The sun is out and the wind is up. Environment Canada has issued a high wind warning for today, which as far as I can tell is like the American equivalent, or the Canadian equivalent to the American small craft advisory. And looking at predict wind, it is going to get really spicy out there in the bay, or in the St. Lawrence, whatever you call the area outside of this bay. But if we stay close to land, it looks like it'll be maybe 10, 15 instead of the 30, 35 that I'm seeing on predict wind. I mean, I say 10 or 15, but it's already blowing like 15. Way back in this corner that we're in right now. So it might be a pretty spicy sailing day. So we put the dinghy back on deck, and so without any further ado, it's time to get underway.
Beautiful, keep going.
So by moving the dead end of our reef out haul forward a little bit, giving us a little more pull down instead of just pull back on our reef mainsail, the sail shape is much better than last time I showed you. So here's a double reefed main. I mean, not perfect, but you can't expect perfect out of a double reef main. I just know it's an improvement. Scene just getting a little bit better every sail. That's the idea. Okay, let me show you what I mean. So here's the dead end for the reef outhaul. You see it ties here, goes to the edge of the sail, down to the end of the boom, and then forward where we can pull it. So when we pull it, we had it before, so it's pulling the sail aft really well, but not down. So now we've led this, you know, almost underneath it. So when we haul, the sail goes aft and down. I think it works a lot better that way.
In the fours?
Yeah. Yeah, we're sailing. Not too fast, 4 knots, but can't complain, we are sailing. We still have a single reef tucked into the main. Not necessary for these conditions, but I think Morgan's gotten kind of nervous with the whole high wind warning in effect today. Doesn't want to get caught with our pants down and our sails too much out. And and besides, we're both reasonably okay with sailing at 4.2 knots. Because again, at least we're sailing. Well, wind speed has increased. We are flirting with 15 knots of wind speed right now, and the boat's picked up to 6 knots of speed. Everybody's happy now. I'm happy. Morgan's happy. Well, Moosey's asleep.
I'm glad we have the working tablet.
Yeah, well, Morgan, I'm kind of curious to know, how does it feel to insist on keeping the reef in, and then 5 minutes later have the wind pick up and the boat sail fast?
Well, it was going to pick up no matter what, because we're going out of the mouth of the bay here. So, yeah.
So you say it was going to pick up eventually anyway, but having it just happen 5 minutes later.
Yeah, just give it a moment. There's like a lull, and it's like we're at 4 knots, 4.5, 4.9 or whatever. And then it just repeated gusts over and over and over again. It's every, like, you'll have a lull for 15 seconds and then it's just a gust and it'll just keep going up and up and up. And I mean, luckily, like, we have two couple reefs in, which, yeah, we could be going faster, but at least we're not on our ear. It's a little bit more controlled, and depending on what the topography is around, the gusts can be pretty strong. So better be safe than sorry with the mountains and the hills going on. And the wind direction isn't what it's been forecasted either, so but at least we're beam reaching.
Take a look at those gusts. We got double tuck in the main. And a deep reef in our working jib. But still, I mean, I see over 7 knots on that chart plotter. So we're definitely not out any speed. That's our hull speed or better. Well, I just relieved Morgan for the 6 p.m. watch. And the name of the game today has been windy, windy, windy. Plenty of wind. And which is great, because we're sailing hella fast. We just keep having to take in, you know, more and more sail, and just sailing with a little bit of jib out and two reefs in the main. Look at the sky back there. It looks really rainy, but the weather radar is showing that we might just get a little bit of rain. It might just skirt us all together. That'd be all right if I can stay dry. But sure, it's hard to appreciate on GoPro camera. You can't like see wind, but probably hear it in the microphone. But you know, we're making better than 7 knots right now. So with the destination that we left this morning, 100 miles to get to, we're showing 37 miles left on the chart plotter. So that's a good way to tick off the miles, just sailing the big wind. I'd say the number one thing I've got going for me today is these oatmeal watch bars that Morgan had baked yesterday. They are banging, and so Morgan, baby, when you see this video, these bars are a knockout. Good work. Yum.
So I would say the MVPs of this voyage are the gimbaled stove. Watch it gimbal. And then the autopilot, because I think by this point we would have been exhausted with the winds and everything. We would have made do, but like, it's exhausting trying to make sure you stay on course, and especially with our bikes being in the back there, like, you can't sit there and look down at the compass. Like, so it's kind of hard to keep your eye on the compass and then keep your eye, you know, what's ahead of you, and then wind and all that jazz. So yeah, the autopilot's the MVP. I don't know how we could do these long stints without it. So I'm pretty thrilled, along with my gimbal stove.
Hey Morgan, do you remember on our first boat, our Pearson 30, Kara, when we had just a Coleman stove that was bolted down to the counter, no gimbals?
Yeah.
How the hell did we ever survive?
I don't know. We didn't do any baking or cooking, I think, while that was going on. Or you had your hand on it the entire time. Same with, like, we didn't have an autopilot.
You're right, we didn't have an autopilot either.
No, we didn't do, like, huge long stints either.
We tried to sail to Florida.
Yeah, but I mean, we didn't do, like, 100 mile days. We only did maybe 50 tops.
That's true.
And it was, like, there was anchorages like all over the place.
Well, it's raining and Lucy's having a snack, which is nice. And we picked our destination for the evening. So we have been sailing now for about 60 miles. We've got about 30 to go. And we're gonna drop the hook in Lark Cove. Reason why we picked that is because that cove borders a provincial park named Blow Me Down Provincial Park. And part of the reason why I picked it is because Blow Me Down sounded like a good time. And so good place as any. And also, when you look closer at that park, there is heads and maybe showers, we'll see, campsites, and then a hiking trail that goes up to this like little mountain. It's like a 3.3 mile hike, like a 650 foot elevation gain. So more like a hill, but I'm expecting the view from there to be pretty cool. And you gotta pick someplace. That place sounds awesome. So we're gonna check it out tomorrow after. So the chart plotter says we'll be getting in about midnight. That sounds all right to me. Get a little sleep, start fresh tomorrow morning with our hike. Well, Morgan, what do you think about this anchorage so far?
Meh.
Yeah. Yeah, your classic one-word answer. Meh. That's how I feel too. It's not beautiful. It's like we're parked right by the freaking Coast Guard station and fishing docks and some neighborhood, and it's not scenic. Very windy. And flat. It's protected, all right. But, I mean, it's just howling wind. Blow Me Down Park. Blow Me Down Park sounds about aptly named, because we were being blown down into our, down below in our boat. We don't even feel like going out there. So, and the noises have got me up. You know, we sailed all night, and it's, you know, we only got 4 hours of sleep, and here I'm up because of the noises of the wind. We're discussing what we're gonna do today. Not the best anchorage though. Nope. Lark's Cove, right near Blow Me Down Provincial Park. It is rainy and windy and yucky, but that's not gonna stop Morgan and I from going ashore and playing. Look how pretty. I mean, for a rainy day, at least we're surrounded by these like crazy, like Jurassic Park hills. Definitely not the most beautiful anchorage you've ever been to, but not bad. It's just got, you know, the Coast Guard boats off the stern. You know, people's houses and a little school. But Main Street is right alongside the back of this cove. So we're gonna dinghy in and then hit the Main Street. And there's so many hiking trails that come off of that street. And so that's why we can't resist. Even though the weather's nasty, it's tempting just to go down below and chill for the day. But then we'll be missing out on a day of hiking, and tomorrow's probably not gonna be any nicer. So let's just get after it. But first, I gotta get this dinghy off the deck. That ain't going anywhere. I don't even think Moosey's gonna ask to come to shore in this weather. He'll probably just say bye to us on the way. Like about a quarter of a mile row. We're gonna be big winds blowing us right to shore. I have no problem with that. It's getting home that's gonna suck. But you know, there's no greater motivator than having your way home just be upwind and you and the oars. I'll get there eventually, I'm sure. The idea is to savor and maintain those dry toes for as long as possible, even if it's just for a few minutes before stepping out into the wild. Is that pretty accurate, Morgan? Yeah. Feeling pretty mountainy at the moment. Somebody was kind enough to put little ropes to hold on to as you climb this super grade up the mountain. That moose. Looks like moose tracks. Starting to open up, you can see the harbor. The views. Ways to go yet, I think.
Is that a golf course?
I don't think that's a golf course.
It's just cleared out.
Well, let's keep going. Blueberries. Always ready to stop for blueberries. Yeah, if only it's hot out, I'd suggest to go for a swim. Yeah. But at the moment,
nope,
all set. Well, I'd say yesterday was pretty fun, despite the kind of cold and cloudy, a little bit rainy weather. We went for a hike, and my legs are a bit sore. And so today we are not hiking, but we are sailing. There's a lot of wind, so it's gonna be pretty sporty out there, but it's a short sail, about 20 miles into Corner Brook, which would be the first actual city, like recognizable city that we would have visited here in Newfoundland. I mean, they've got coffee shop, they got a Walmart. We're not necessarily gonna hit the Walmart, but we do need to get some groceries on board, garbage off, to see if we can get some fuel, showers, laundry, all that stuff that's good to refresh when you get to civilization. Also, Morgan's bicycle is acting up. She's got this creak coming from her cassette, and so between her cassette and FreeHub. I don't have the tools to fix that, and so we're gonna bring it into a bicycle repair guy, and hopefully he can just fix it and doesn't wanna keep it overnight, because we are anxious to keep moving on our trip. We don't like sitting and waiting for delays, but we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. Hopefully the mechanic can just, fix up her bike. Yeah, a couple extra steps today to get underway. We tied the dinghy to the bow. We're gonna start with a double reef tucked into the main. We're gonna set it that way. It's pretty windy in here, and it might get windier as we get around the corner here, because we're at a very protected cove. Morgan's obviously hauling the anchor. I'm gonna go down below and flake the anchor chain, get this boat going. Well, so long, Lark Harbor. We're heading to Bay of Islands Yacht Club. They haven't answered the call when I tried to call ahead, so I'm assuming that's where we're going tonight. We'll see. But the nice thing about the yacht club, we haven't spent hardly any money on this trip. We anchor everywhere, and so we'll spend a little money, but we'll be able to plug into the dock, get the shore power. Moosey can jump on and off the boat as he pleases, and they'll have laundry, showers, and fuel and water available. So we'll top off the boat for one night. It's almost like staying in a hotel room when you're hiking, you know? The cliffs are really tall and the water is really deep here. I mean, that's right next to the boat. And we're in 115 feet of water here. And I could throw a rock and bounce it off the cliff. I mean, it makes places to anchor kind of few and far between. It's not like we're days and days away from like an anchorage. It's not that bad, but you just gotta find somewhere that's not like bottomless ocean to drop your anchor. And that can be a little bit challenging. Makes trip planning really important, because you don't wanna be like tired and, you know, haven't been on watch and, you know, we're both sleep deprived and being like, now where are we gonna anchor? That would be a terrible plan. Best to just do a little bit of planning ahead of time, get an idea about where you're gonna go for a plan A and a plan B. Hard to beat the scenery here. I know, maybe just wasted a lot of camera in time on just looking at hills, but it's just so dramatic. I don't know what kind of emotion it brings up, but it's something to see. Well, so much for getting hammered with that wind. The windiest part we saw today was in that cove we just left. So the wind's pretty light. We're just motoring into it because the direction is right on the nose. And instead of tacking back and forth all day in this light breeze, we're just gonna motor for 3 hours and get this boat tied up. We got a lot of errands to do today, so that seems like the best choice. What do you think, Morgan? Not bad, right?
Yeah, not bad.
Not bad. No. We're probably 10 to 15 knots of wind, and we're close hauled. We are gonna beat the weather to get in. It was just a shame motoring around our sailboat. So what else are we gonna do today? So we're gonna go sailing. So full sail.
The wind is puttering out. Wah, wah, wah.
Yeah.
And the fog's rolling in.
Well, at least we tried. It looks like we're gonna be able to do our errands after all, because we're gonna start the motor and just get in there, because we tried sailing, and we're not going very fast.
It's what we were hoping for the last 2 days.
Hoping for? You're hoping to go at 2 knots?
No, for anchoring, you know.
Oh, once the anchor's down, that's what you're hoping. Yeah, we've been pretty windy at anchorage lately. At least it's not rolly. Like, that's the real problem. Wind just pulls the anchor tight. That's not that big of a deal. It's the swells when your boat is up and down. Not only does it make it really hard to do anything and get some sleep, but also you can pull that anchor out of the mud when the waves are up. So, a little wind don't bug me. I mean, it'd be better if it was just flat. Fixing to put the boat dockside, and Moosey's gonna have access to jump on and off it. So people don't mistake him for a stray. We're gonna put his kitty harness on him, something he hasn't worn in a really long time. He's sleeping right now, and he's about to get a rude awakening. Good. Get ready, dock lines and fenders. We're making our approach to Bay of Islands Yacht Club. Looks pretty packed from here, but it's hard to tell what's behind the breakwater. So we'll see what it looks like as we get closer. Boats, boats, boats. We've got boats at the yacht club. Club life. It sucks paying $40, but we've got garbages going. We've got water in the tank. The harbor master was really kind and gave us a ride to the gas station. I was able to fill a couple of jerry cans of diesel. Showers, laundry. We're going for a bike ride. bike ride into town for groceries, and Morgan's having a bike issue. We're gonna take it into the bike shop, get it fixed up, and yeah, so fun plan for the day, going for a bike ride.